Hey guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. I'm finally back over here after a whole break of 1 month, more than a month actually. And I missed a lot about posting videos on YouTube, and I missed all of you beautiful people as well. Do let me know how you are doing. And in this particular video, I'm just gonna give you updates of what I have been through, what I've been doing this past 1 month, and why I haven't been posting on any social media platforms that I have. So this video is just gonna be a bit of philosophical, but if you would want to stay, then you can stay till the end, because towards the end I'm gonna share with you 5 learnings that I had during this period of breakdown, right? So yeah, if this interests you, then please make sure you watch till the end of this video. And I'm just gonna give you a brief of what's going on and what I've been doing and what's going to come in the future. So having said that, without much ado, let's jump right inside the video. So what happened in the past 1 month? Why wasn't I posting any videos? Now there are a series of events that happened, but at first, if you remember, during the early July, I was posting a lot of content on the sales funnels I was making, right? And making of those sales funnels, I was completely occupied with the different client works that I had got, and I was completely focusing on working with them alone instead of making YouTube videos, because these consume a lot of time, right? So that was the complete July went through making sales funnels for clients, and also for the strategy sessions that I was doing then. And right after that, what happened is my graduation final semester exams kicked in. It started from 2nd of August and it ended at 6th of August. However, we didn't study for that because it was based on online mode. We still got through it. And right now, we are a bit of graduation. We completed it. The exams are done and everything is done. We do not have to look back at it again. Finally, I can say that my graduation career is completely done and dusted.
Oh my God! Wow! Oh my God!
Right, so I'm very much excited to start this work full on, and I'm going to do that from now on until who knows. So that's what happened, and right after that I actually went into the state of depression because of a few reasons. The first one was that when I was completely involved in all the works that I was doing, I couldn't have time for other people. So I was pretty much occupied with it, and when I needed them, I couldn't have them, right? Because of a lot of reasons. So I actually wanted to talk to somebody at the end of the day, because when I have completed a lot of stuff and I am going through a lot of stuff that I need to talk about. But I didn't have somebody to talk to, and this was just eating me from within, and I had to have somebody to talk to. So that's the reason I entered into this particular state, and I wasn't sure of what I would want to do. Because of this reason, I spent the next couple of weeks after the exam completely exhausted. I didn't do a lot of work, and I was completely procrastinating, thinking that I would be doing the work on the next day, I would be starting fresh and everything from the next day, but I never started. This was the reason that I decided that I would give myself 1 week to reminisce my past and accept every single thing that I thought was wrong, just accept the fact and move on. So I gave myself 1 week, and that week ended just yesterday. I'm making this video in night, almost midnight over here on Monday, so it ended yesterday. And it went pretty awesome. I'll be talking about that towards the end of the video by giving special thanks, but right now it's done, and that's the reason I wasn't able to post for the 1 month continuously. So during this period, I learned a lot of things, innumerable things that I could ever think of, and I picked out the best 5 lessons that I learned through this entire period, and I just wanted to share it with you so that you can learn from my mistakes. Let's start with it. The first learning that I had is people and relationships are always greater than money. Now, you would say that this is very cliche and we all know about this, but do you? Because even if you make a lot of money, where do you think you would be spending it? Buying yourself a car, going on a solo vacation? Well, I don't feel so. A relationship doesn't have to be a boyfriend or a girlfriend. A relationship can be within some friends, within your parents, within your family, right? And if your relationships are not strong enough and you have focused your entire life in just making money, you have lost a lot of things behind. And that's a very precious thing. What do you think made me through this breakdown? Relationships or money? The second thing that I learned is having no expectations of anybody. Even if it's your parents, even if it's your friends, even if it's your best friends, even if it's your girlfriend, do not have any kind of expectations. Because when you have expectations that the other person has no idea about, that they cannot fulfill, and they are clueless, they do not even know what they need to do, and you have already presumed that they would be doing this for you. How does that even make sense, right? This is such a stupid term, having expectations, right? So when you're having expectations and the other person doesn't do it, you are disappointed for an act they didn't have to even do, right? So have no expectations of anybody but yourself. Third, be kind, not nice. One of my friends taught this amazing lesson to me, the difference between being kind and being nice. When you are being nice, you do things and you expect things in return. Well, just as a saying, if you give a piece of favor to me, and I would want you to give me a favor in the future for this, I am being nice to you. I'm not being kind. When you are being kind, you give things and you do not expect anything in return. So let's say you have got a new person come up inside of your Instagram account and ask a very big question, and you are like, okay, I'm gonna give you a piece of advice on this. You just send him a voice note and there the conversation ends. You do not expect that person to come up after a year and give an advice back to you. No, that's being kind. And you can see how small of kindness you can do on a daily basis, right? You can do even way higher than that, but you understand my point. Be kind, not nice. Number four, live the moments. On this entire 1 week, I understood the importance of living the moments. Well, I knew that this time would be flying like crazy, and it did. I thought that this 1 week that I had a gap where I could enjoy my whole thing, it just passed like a day, right? It was so fast, I couldn't even hold a breath to think about the different things that I could do in this 1 week, right? I was playing video games, I was watching Netflix and other movies as well, and I was going out, enjoying the nature, go on cycling, joined a gym, and did a lot of things. But I knew that it would pass by very, very fast, and I lived each and every moment with a person. And that actually helped me understand the importance of this small moments that will make you happy from within. And how do you think I came up after that? Here I am, right? So living the moments can help you increase your productivity in every single thing just by enjoying the one moment that you are living. The final one is a bit complicated, the fifth one. Is that in order to let go of something, you have to accept the fact that you were wrong or your thoughts wouldn't change a thing. Let me explain this to you. So what happened was my ex actually blocked all of my accounts about 4 to 5 months ago. Till since then I didn't have any conversation with her, but I was still watching her Instagram stories and everything from an anonymous account. So she has a StudyGram account, as a matter of fact, you can go and see it, it's nerdy.tales, and it's a very good account, has more than 6500 by the time you would be watching it, it would be more than 7k followers right now, and she's doing fantastic work. And I happened to go inside of her Instagram account while she was having her first live on Instagram. And I went inside of the live and I was happy than anything else. because I remember the day when I did my first live and she was the only person who was present in that live. You see how amazing this was, and I was pretty much excited because I wanted to put a comment, I wanted to cheer her and do everything, but I couldn't, because if I did, then it would just spoil her mood, spoil the first live that she did. So I didn't spoil it. I was just watching and I was just blushing. I was thinking like, damn, like, she's doing so good. I was just throwing all the hearts that we have inside the Instagram lives. And I was so excited and so happy for that. And recently, I had a conversation with her within this week's gap from an anonymous account, being an anonymous person. And we had a conversation. It was wonderful. She didn't know it was me, maybe. But during that conversation, we came up to talking about her boyfriend. And she said that he actually helped her find out what she really wanted. She is actually doing CA, so I thought that she loved CA the entire time we were together, and because she was chasing CA for a very long time. And I was like, okay, cool. So now that you are almost achieving, and how does it feel? And she was like, I do not love CA, I just love learning a lot of new things and everything of that sort. So that her new boyfriend was able to help her figure out what she really wanted, and this didn't spoil my mood or anything. This actually made me a lot happier. For the next couple of days, I couldn't take this that he did something that I couldn't do myself for an entire year, and he did that being a very new person. I couldn't accept it, but guess what? When I did, I moved on, right? So accepting that he could do something that I wasn't able to do for a very long time helped me move on when every other thought got me attached to it. So you see, the best way to letting go is to accepting the facts that are already on the table. Even if you do not want to accept it, it's just a truth that you cannot change. So that's what can help you to move on from things, maybe. So these were the five learnings that I learned during this entire period, and I hope this will help you as well. So at the end of this video, I would like to thank my best friend Abhi for doing all of these amazing things this entire week that actually made it worth it to go through this. And I am totally happy from within after this entire week's gap, and I'm totally thankful to you for doing all of these amazing things. We spent a lot of time together and it was fantastic. It was wonderful that I was blessed with having a friend like you. It was wonderful, and I would like to thank her for each and everything she did for me for the past 5 years of our friendship. And I'm totally blessed to have her in my life. I know she wouldn't be watching this, but this is just a way that I would want to show my gratitude to her, because she so much deserves it. If somebody deserves it, it should be her. So this will be it for the entire video. I hope you enjoyed. At the end, I would just like to close this entire video with just one line, that life has to go on. Why stick with things in the past? Just move on, accept it and move on. So that will be all for this video. I hope you enjoyed, and I will be seeing you in the future video real soon, completely based on sales funnels, no more philosophical stuff. We'll be getting back with the 1 minute pro funnel series as well, also the must strategy videos. Everything is gonna get back and on track real soon. So make sure you hit the subscribe button and also like this video if you did, and I will be seeing you in the next one. Till then, stay safe, stay home, and keep creating for a change.